There are many ways to boost your performance in VR. Normally, the biggest factor for this is your video card, which, depending on where you live, may be very difficult to get a hold of right now. Supply chain issues, chip shortages, scalpers, flippers, crypto miners, and just generally people wanting to game more, working at home, all of these are factors on why it can be difficult to get a video card right now. There are many tricks and methods to get more life out of your video card, like combining two similar video cards via software to force two cards into SLI using a program called Different SLI Auto. A more difficult method is to take RAM chips off of one card and adding it to another card using a heat gun and reballing a solder. Things like water cooling and better thermal paste can also boost the performance. Today I'm going to show you the easier ways to boost your VR performance using your current card. The first method is Amd Fsr, which works on AMD, Nvidia, and Intel HD graphics cards. First, download and open the zip file with the Fsr files. Then find the game you want to modify in your Steam library, or wherever it is installed. In Steam, right-click the game and select Properties. Then navigate to Local Files and select Browse. We are then going to use the search bar to find the two files we want to replace. If you find multiples of OpenVR DLL or Config, then right-click and open file location so you can modify them individually. I always rename the original file with -old before replacing it. That way, if the mod doesn't work or it crashes, you can always go back and replace it with the original. Once you have replaced both the OpenVR files in the game folder locations, you should be able to run the game with better performance. This Spider-Man game originally had no sound and would crash when trying to load or run at 5 FPS. I can now enjoy it on my 1050 Ti. So what is AMD FSR? Well, it's a type of rendering technique that boosts frame rates in games by scaling the resolution. In VR, the resolution on the outer edges is lower and the resolution in the center is higher. This allows for a great boost that allows you to try things that you normally wouldn't be able to. Now, it is worth noting that this will only work on games that utilize the Unity engine or the Unreal engine. Let's do this mod one more time, but on Doom VFR, which flat out could not play on this card. Revisiting compatibility for just a second, while this will work on games that utilize Unity and Unreal, games like Half-Life Alyx will not work on this mod. And games that were not originally intended for VR, like Hellblade VR Edition, may run into issues as well. However, for games that don't utilize Unity and Unreal, we do have one more trick up our sleeves for Nvidia cards. The first thing we want to do is to update our Nvidia drivers. You technically should be doing this anyways, if you have an Nvidia card. Once you've updated your drivers, you can go to the Nvidia control panel and set it to performance over quality. Last but not least, download a program called Msi Afterburner. This is overclocking software for your video card. Please note you must be very careful with this program as it can damage your card if done incorrectly, whereas AMD FSR will not damage your card, you may just have to reinstall a game. You do not need an MSI card to do this. Any brand with an Nvidia chipset will work, like PNY, EVGA, etc. For my 1050 Ti, I utilized two separate configurations, one on the low end and one on the high end. You really should check multiple forums and multiple tutorials for your card to find the best settings and so you don't break your card. Settings can vary greatly from card to card, so please do your research. Now, the cool thing is you most certainly can combine MSI Afterburner and AMD FSR on the Unity and Unreal games, and you will boost your performance even more. To measure your performance increases on MSI Afterburner, you can use Steam VR Performance Test. This test will unfortunately not work with AMD FSR as it does not utilize the correct engine. Well, at any rate, I hope you found this informative. I hope AMD FSR works for you well, or MSI Afterburner works for you well to boost your frame rate or just boost your performance, or in the case of the two games I showed, able to actually play things that I can't play or couldn't play in the past. It is worth noting that for this tutorial, I used a 1050 Ti 4GB, and I had a Windows mixed reality headset when filming. I'm sorry I didn't go over different auto SLI. It is kind of a pain tutorial-wise, and a little bit more difficult to get it working. There are plenty of tutorials out there on different methods on how to try to do it. Every time I've gotten it to work, I've fumbled into it, or I've basically just magically got it working out of nowhere. But once it's set up, it does work pretty well. Now, as far as moving RAM chips from one card to another, you really need some decent soldering skills. And in all honesty, I can do it, but I have a lot of failure as well. Until next time, have a great one.